legal, everyone, if the drug was legalized, people would then have to go to their doctor to get the prescription for it as opposed to getting it on the black market. And so they would have to like declare that they are taking this whatever drug hormone, so then in sports enhancement wouldn't.
That's not so fair.
But I mean,
what are they going to ask the doctor?
Well,
like,
everyone takes it,
that's
who's going to win.
No, they said, no, it's legal, right? You gotta get the prescription, so what are they gonna do, like, ask the doctor?
You go to the doctor.
But the problem is that sports as we know, would be ridiculous.
But wouldn't it, if everyone was on it, wouldn't it, like, level the playing field for everyone, like, it'd be the normal.
But if someone had...
But I also think it's fit, like, I don't see the point in, like, it takes away, if we're talking about athletics, I think it just takes away from the whole aspect of, like, competition. Yes, there's going to be competition between, like, whose muscles are bigger, like, who has, like, the ability to, like, you know, make that home run or whatever. But, like, it also takes away from sports as we know it from the past, like, hundreds of years. And, like, you hear about all these great athletes, like, in the past who weren't on steroids, and then you hear about, or hormones or whatever, like, now you're hearing about, you know, all these people that who are, like, idolized, like, all these little kids, because they can do all these great things, and then, like, they grow up and they find out, like, really, it was kind of all fake. It wasn't natural ability, and I think that's kind of, like, what sports is about, and you're enhancing yourself to the point where you are pushing yourself to be somewhere where your body has never been, or anybody's body has ever been, and like, that's not real.
At the same time, they talked about how, like, you should look at your beaks, love, and eat mushrooms, like, that's the body, so, do other, like, bigger, methods of exercise. So, they asked the question of, like, is it normal to enhance yourself by any means necessary?
Also talked about how prosropin is the name of the drug that the issues, and how when you're taking it as a performance enhancement, because it's a natural hormone that your body produces, it's really difficult to identify that people who are taking it. So I mean, how do you control that? Like when it's on a black market to start with, so there's no control. Plus the fact that it's really difficult to identify. I mean, there's some cases where it has been in recently, but like a lot of them, it's a natural something that your body produces. How do you regulate that?
I think that's it, yeah. Like, it doesn't feel better, right? If it's like a blood test, it's going to find better or something. It's just like a whole different process.
I think you brought up three really great points that the future requires further discussion. One being, to legalize or not to legalize, we could, instead of dangerous black market drugs, legalize it, control it, make it safer, and help society with earning money off of that product, taxes to support society. I mean, what is another example of something that you can find on the black market, especially on campuses? Yes.
Yeah.
A second point that you brought up, that I can think about is, we talk about enhancing our bodies, but is there really a difference between enhancing our bodies and enhancing the equipment that we use in the sports we do? For example, pole vaulting poles with the technology of carbon fiber poles and whatnot. Or from my own personal perspective, going from large wooden heavy boats to thin, solid carbon fiber boats and oars and moving seas. Every advance at first was resisted until it was accepted and everyone got on board and jumped up board with the same better equipment. And a third point was fair. How do you define fair? And do things really need to be fair? So, but does anyone have any last minute or a last comment to make? So,
I think it's also when it comes to competition and being decisions, because I've been experimenting my life and it's like an individual thing for me, but as opposed to like some other people where it's like team sports. You're always, I mean, there's people who you're
stance, but yourself as your number one competitor, so like, does it really matter? I mean, it matters because of what other people think of you, but does it matter because you know that you're improving or not
improving? So, comparing yourself to yourself
versus other people, because I mean, what good is it when you're like at a competition or something and you're like, God, that girl beat me, like she sucks or whatever, but like, in, you're at other competitions, but it's just like, how did I compare from the last time that I competed?
That would be nice if everybody thought that way, but let's be real. You lose, and you're like, you bitch. Like, you're going to be mad about it, because not everything is like candy cane and lollipops. Like, if somebody beats me, I'm going to be pissed. Like, that makes me want to work harder. And that, I mean, yes, that's like the personal drive where it's like, okay, like, Lexi, you need to get your ass back in the pool. Sorry. You need to get back in the pool and, like, do your own thing so that you can beat her the next time. But
yeah.
But in reality, if somebody beats you, you're not going to be like, better.
You're always comparing yourself to other people.
Exactly. Yeah. It's innate. It's human. Like, if somebody beats you on the soccer field, whichever you play soccer, like, obviously you're going to be pissed. Like, it's annoying. Like, you know? And there's a difference between being, like, a sore loser and, like it's what makes you better, comparing yourself to other people and saying, okay, well, she did this. Now I have to do this so that I can get better. It's just, it's innate.
Competitive drive.
Yeah.
I think it's true to a certain point, but I think it's also that, like, how good is it when you get all pissy about, like, the other people being with you, when you don't really have control over the other people being with you, except for how you drive your own personal self, like, how much you train, it's not how others train around you. So I feel like it is, like, you are competitive around the other people because you're in a sport and you're competing against other people, but ultimately you're want to be better, so it's against yourself. So, but I think, like, I used to be more like that, where in this game where I would just, like, come down and, like, other girls would, like, beat me, and that would be, like, ugh, like, that sucks, or one of my teammates would, or something like that. But, like, over time, I think it just develops into, like, it being more about you rather than the people around you. Because, I mean, getting upset over, like, it again and again, I don't know how productive that is.
I think it depends on the person and how they take it. I mean, yeah. Some people might take it like you take it, and some people might take it out of the place. I think it depends on the person. I can't just be like, this is how
yeah,
it's
no, yeah. Totally adaptive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's totally different.
Interesting. I like what you brought up for Zach, and it's the ability to really understand the pressure. So, I guess we're talking about like H2 and H2 later, we're talking about like people in the orchestra and all this stuff, and people take those back and do it. That's very cool.
All right, why don't we take a break? 5 minutes. Get up, stretch. If you could do me a favor and align the chairs back to the
Yeah.